In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can add comment section for free in Webflow. As you know, when you have a blog on your Webflow website, there is no native option to include comment section into your blog posts. And this is what I found as a third-party solution by Discuss, and I'm going to walk you through the steps on how you can implement it on your website. If in any case you experience some difficulty, please contact your Webflow developer, or even you can reach out to me if you need any assistance with this. And this is the default icon I have chosen for the guests that will leave a comment. After you write your comment, you will be asked to log in with one of these options here, or you can leave your name, email, create a password, agree with those that you agree, and then submit your comment. Or there's another option as well where you can just simply react to a different story with one of the reactions here, and you don't want to leave a comment, which is also fine, but at least there will be some kind of feedback on the topic that you have written, and you will see what your audience thinks about your work. Now let's check the Discuss portal. Here is the landing page or their homepage. I'm going to pricing so I can show you the current prices in 2025. As you can see, you have a Plus, Pro, Business, but there is no free account available. But what you want to do is go here and get started and create your account or log in with one of these social medias profiles that are offered. Since I already have my account, I will go back and I will just log in. And once I create my account as someone who has a blog, I will log in as a publisher, not a commenter. So once you get into your Discuss profile, you would like to add your website from the drop down here. And when you click new, you will be asked to input some of the details about your website. You can select organization you have already added it to your profile, the website name or the URL, the category of your website, and the language that is on your website, and then create a site. After completing the steps of creating your site, you will get a welcome message like this one, and you will see here that you have selected a free ad supported version of Discuss, and in your comment section there might be appearing some ad, so you have to go into the settings and opt in or out of the version of the ads and their location that you want to have and how you want them to present on your website. You can tweak lots of other settings and moderation and all other things in the panel, but that's for another video. If you enjoyed this video and you find it useful, make sure to leave a like, subscribe for more videos, and turn on the bell. And as you can see, we have different versions of web builders here, but we don't see Webflow. So what we have to do, we have to click here. And I highly advise you, if you're not a technical person and you're not sure how to do it step by step, even though I will show you in this tutorial, to still watch the tutorials and go over the important details. One thing I need to mention is that when you copy this code here, which you will need to attach to your embed element in your Webflow page, you need to also remove the comment symbols here that are slash and a star, and I will show you how and why later on. And now that we are here, and that here is the blog post template. So whenever I want to write a blog post, I will have the same layout for every single one of them. And of course, I'm using the CMS option, so it can use the template page, but also retrieve the data from the CMS and apply it to every single blog post. And here's how it looks like for my blog posts. For my blog posts, I have category name, have a collection name, post, and within the collection field, I have these elements here. And in every single post, which is a collection item, looks like name, slug, date, which are the default settings you have for this. Then you have the meta description, the blog post content or the body, where you can import all of the text and the images. If you already create blog posts, you know that whatever is visualized here is not the same that you once you post it. As you can see here, the images look much bigger, but you can always adjust them from the settings here on the top. And so let's see how we can add this comment section within our blog template page. As you can see here under the whole blog post, so I'm going here into the navigator and I'm going to find section where is the blog post. Here is called hero stack because it's the only element that I have after the banner and my navigation. Then I added a new section, empty section, which I named comment section, and within that comment section I also included a div, a container where I would also add the code embedded element, which I added with the command K on Mac, and I typed code embedded, and this was the option that was included. This was the option that was provided. So after I press that, I paste the code here with this element, and as I said, I'm going to remove the comment here or the slash and the star. Once you create your site on the discuss platform, as you can see, you will have already the URL provided here, but once you paste the code within the embedded element, you would need to also link it to the specific page and the element that you need to connect it with. So for this case we need a page URL and page identifier. For the first one, which is the page URL, we need to go to, we will save this for now and close it, and we will go back to the CMS, we will go to the blog posts and the settings, and then down here we will see the collection URL. We're gonna copy this one by clicking on it. We're gonna go back here, click the cog, and then within the page URL we're going to delete this and we're gonna paste it. So we can get the template URL for every single blog post and how it will be generated from now on. So this is the parent basically, and it comes with the slash post slash blog post page. So the way it works is that the CMS will take on the URL created from your blog post title, and it will generate that link here for every single blog post dynamically, and I will show you how it looks like in life. For example, this is my blog. As you can see here, it ends with blog, but whenever I click on time left blog post, it will take that title immediately and turn it into the URL. So this is how this here works. Now we also need to find the page identifier. Again, we're gonna close and save, and for that purpose we would need to go here, and for this element here that I have already added, it's called blog post comment, but since we are demonstrating on this one, I will need to add another one here. Okay, we copy this ID here and we go back to the embedded element and we replace the page identifier with that code embedded ID. As you can see here, save and close. Once you paste this code into your blog post page, you can complete also the setup of your website, and you can paste here the name and the website URL and much more details about it. You can also choose what kind of moderation you want to have on your comments, balance, strict, whatever. Choose whatever you want, and then you can also install other things related to blog posts and comment sections. Hope this tutorial was straightforward enough for you to do it by yourself. Make sure you have all the links matching with your discuss profile, with the code that they provide you, and when you paste it into the embedded code as well. Make sure you pick up the right links in terms of page URL for the blog posts and also the page identifier, which is the code embedded ID. If you have any questions, make sure to leave them in the comments below, and if you have any suggestions for future tutorials, also you can send me a message on social media or leave a comment here. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel, and if you like this video, please make sure to share it with your audience. See you in the next one. Bye.